So hello students, welcome back to a new session or new video in which we will be discussing about the instantaneous center method of finding out the angular velocity of the given link and a linear velocity of the given points or slider, okay, using a slider crank mechanism. So this is the second question or second problem, okay, in this particular method, that is the IC method. Okay, so here is the problem given. So that is, locate all the instantaneous centers of the slider crank mechanism as shown in figure. So this is the given diagram or figure. So in this, we have to locate all the instantaneous centers. So the length of crank OB is given as 100 millimeter and CR and AB. Okay, this, so the connecting rod AB is 400 millimeters. So if the crank rotates at 10 radians per second clockwise, so angular velocity is given, that is the crank angular velocity OB, okay, omega OB is given as 10 radians per second. We need to find out the angular velocity of AB and velocity of slider A. So this is the slider A. Okay, so the angle BOA is given as 45 degrees. Okay, now first of all, what you need to do is, as discussed in the first problem, okay, we need to draw the space diagram or the configuration diagram very neatly, because that is used to locate the ICs, that is used to locate the ICs. Okay, so now let us start with the space diagram or the configuration diagram. Draw the given, okay, draw the given diagram using the dimensions, and scale will be taken as 100 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. So draw a line first, indicating OA. Now using 45 degree, draw a line which indicates the crank OB. Now using the dimension, the given dimension of AB, construct the AB also. So this is the slider A, which will be moving horizontally. Okay, which will be moving horizontally due to the motion of or rotation of the crank OB. Now, first of all, we need to find out how many ICs can be located in this given mechanism. So for that, we have a formula, that is N is equal to capital N is equal to N into N minus 1 divided by 2. So given in the given mechanism, four links are there. Therefore, N will be equal to, or the number of ICs will be equal to 6. So which are those ICs? 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, and 3, 4. Now let us locate the available ICs here. So link 1 with link 2 will have the IC 1, 2 at point O. Link 2 and link 3 at point B, we can get an IC 2, 3. Link 3 and link 4 will have an IC 3, 4. Okay, at that point, particular point. Okay, so again, we have link 1 and 4. Link 1 is fixed and the fourth link is a slider. So the instantaneous center for a slider with respect to the fixed point is always given or shown perpendicular to that particular point. And one more thing, very important thing, is at infinity. Okay, we do not know the distance of that, so at infinity. So just draw perpendicular lines for both the points L1 and L4, okay, or okay, wherever you have the, see, and you should write I14 at infinity. Okay, you should extend the line below also and show I14 at infinity. So as I told you, so remember this, a slider with a fixed point, with respect to a fixed point, okay, will have its instantaneous center, okay, located perpendicular to it at infinity. So these are the ICs which we can locate using the given diagram or given mechanism. So now we need to think about the ICs which we do not have here. Okay, that is 1, 3 and 2, 4. 1, 3 and 2, 4. So 1, 2, 1, 4, 2, 3 and 3, 4. All of them have been located. Remaining is 1, 3 and 2, 4. So in order to find them and locate them, so we can go for using a circular method as discussed earlier. So okay, draw a circle with any radius of your choice. No issues at all. Okay, so then cut four points. No need to take compass or anything. Just cut four points, okay? Because it is of no use. So mark them as the links 1, 2, 3, and 4. So connect 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1, and 4 to 1. So the first point to be located, or the first IC to be located as 1, 3, correct? So what we'll do is we will connect 1 to 3, okay, using a dotted line. We will connect 1 to 3 using a dotted line. So when you connect 1 to 3, okay, so you can see that it is enclosed by two triangles on both the sides. It is enclosed by two triangles on both the sides. So 1, 3, okay, has two triangles on both the sides. That is 1, 4, 3, 4. So see, this is 1, 4. Then this is 3, 4. 1, 4, and 3, 4. Second one is 1, 2, and 2, 3. So 1, 2, and 2, 3. See, 1, 2, and 2, 3. So as you can see, 1, 4, and 3, 4 lie in the same line. 1, 2, and 2, 3 lie in a same line. Lie in the same line. Okay. So let us now see the second instantaneous center to be located, and that is 2 to 4. So before that, what we'll do is we'll extend the line from, see, already we have extended line from 2, 4 to 1, 4. It is already there. So they both lie in the same line. What we can do is 1, 2, and 2, 3. See this, okay, 1, 2, and 2, 3. Just extend a line from here. Then it will meet or intersect the line at this particular point. This is your 1, 3. This is your 1, 3. So we have located the other instantaneous center. Now we need to locate another instantaneous center, that is 2, 4. Now connect 2 to 4. Okay, 2 to 4 or 2, 4 again surrounds or is surrounded by two triangles. One is 1, 2, and 1, 4. Okay, other is 2, 3, and 3, 4. So where is 1, 2, and 1, 4? See, 1, 2. Okay, and 1, 4. This is the line 1, 2, and 1, 4. Okay, and next you have 2, 3. You see here, this is 2, 3, and this is 2, 4. So when you extend line from 2, 3, and 2, 4, which lie on the same line, okay, on a straight line, so it will intersect this line, okay, 1, 2, 1, 4. That point is your new or IC 2, 4. So remaining thing is very simple. You can calculate omega b o, maybe, yes, the given angular velocity as well as the linear velocity using the relation which has been given already. Okay, that is omega AB. Okay, we need to calculate the angular velocity of the link AB or connecting rod AB. So VAB, omega AB will be equal to VA by I, see here, omega A, that is AB. For these two links, so this is the common IC. This is the common IC. So therefore, I13A and VB divided by I13B. Okay, so what we can do is we can take omega AB is equal to VB by I13B. We know omega AB. So omega AB is 10, and OB, when we measure, okay. The given dimension for OB is 0.1 millimeter. So VB will be equal to 1 meter per second. VB will be equal to 1 meter per second. Now, that is equal to, that is VB by I13B or omega AB is equal to 1 by, that is VB by I13B. So measure I13B, see here. This is I13 and this is B. So measure this line. So it will come around 0.58, okay, meters. So omega AB is equal to 1 divided by 0.58. So therefore, omega AB will be equal to, so omega AB will be equal to 1.72 radians per second. Okay, we have calculated VB using omega OB into OB. Omega OB is given in the problem, that is 10, okay, 10 radians per second. And we know OB, that is 0.1. So that will be equal to 1 meter per second. Input that data here and you can find out omega AB. So once you have find out omega AB, what you can do is you can just use that value. Okay. So omega V, in order to find out VA, that is omega AB is equal to VA by I13A. So now find out I13A or measure I13A. So once you measure it, it will be equal to 0.49. Okay. Omega AB, you know, so input that data, therefore VA is equal to 0.842 meter per second. So this is how we need to calculate velocity. Okay. Angular velocity as well as linear velocity for the given link or the point. Okay. Of the given mechanism. So hope you have understood this. Next problem, we will take a bit complex problem in which we will take 6 links so that the ICs are increased. Okay. I'll explain until how to find out the values, how to find out the ICs and how to find out the values. So you have to continue it and find the values for them. Find the values for them finally. Okay. That's all for today. Thank you guys. Meet you in the next lecture or next video.